broadcast giant MultiChoice had the SABC against the wall? That's former SABC CEO Lula Mamokobo's testimony at the State Capture Inquiry. She says her efforts to amend clauses in the controversial contract between MultiChoice and SABC was met with resistance even from some within the SABC.
There was no way that I could have sat there and agreed that the law be broken. A policy statement from government becomes law. There was no way I could have been party to that happening. So that meeting had discussed quite intensely. It was, shall I say, there was a little bit of camaraderie in that meeting. There was a little bit of joking backwards and
between
forwards.
Between MultiChoice and SABC.
But there was absolute clarity on things that should not have been in discussion as being included in the contract. Therefore, it was quite surprising when I read the letter that they sent to Mr. Motsoeneng, that those clauses were still there.
Continuing with her testimony, she told the commission how former SABC COO Claudia Motsoeneng bragged about being close to former President Jacob Zuma.
He boasted to me many times how he was close to the president, how he had been at the president's house until 2 a.m., how this or the other president. And I think I mentioned in the previous session when I sat in front of future that there would be ministers coming to see Mr. Motsoeneng and not me.
Meanwhile, the commission also heard the testimony about the Amigo case, which implicates KZN ANC senior politicians. On the stand, Colonel Johannes Duploy. Duploy told the inquiry that the awarding of a contract that was for the procurement of 20 water purification plants. Duploy told the inquiry that the awarding of a contract that was for the procurement of 20 water purification plants was manipulated.
Among all those years, I'm talking about 6, 7, this thing started in 2009, so the case is on 9 to 11 years, but let's say the last 6 years, I've never heard of the reasons or never given an opportunity to see what can we do to satisfy the NPA.
The commission resumes on Thursday. Nhlanhla Khatlhane, SABC News, Johannesburg.